Reporting from Arkham Asylum, this is Gotham Rogues. In this video, we take a look at the storyline, Batman and the War of Jokes and Riddles. I'm pretty much the last comics YouTuber to review this, but here we go. War of Jokes and Riddles is an 8-part arc written by Tom King and penciled by Mikhail Janin. It was published across Batman Volume 2, issues 25-32 in 2017. In the War of Jokes and Riddles, Batman relates to his fiancée Selina Kyle the story of when early in his career, the Joker and Riddler went to war with each other. It started when both realized neither could let the other kill Batman, as they had to do it themselves. So a war erupted, and all Gotham rogues were forced to choose sides, for some reason, join Joker or Riddler. So yeah, that's the plot, I guess. Of course I have to mention the big reveal at the end, so spoiler alert. The true reason behind the war is that Riddler wants to make Joker laugh again. In the story, Joker is unable to laugh as his battles with Batman have grown stale. It's always the same over and over, Joker getting his ass kicked by bats. It's predictable, and thus not funny anymore. Riddler orchestrates an elaborate plot with his war as a front. The true goal involves the creation of a new rogue, the most pathetic supervillain ever known, Kite Man, and having this ridiculous loser be the key in Riddler's own defeat in the war. The idea is that it's so silly, Kite Man beating Riddler and ending the war, the Joker has to laugh again. So Eddie sets in motion the events that leads to Charlie Brown adopting the persona of Kite Man, then taking Joker's side, and at the end, it is Kite Man collaborating with Batman who brings Eddie down, right before the nose of Joker. And it was all planned by Eddie. One nice, ridiculously convoluted scheme. And the dumbest thing I've ever seen. I guess this leads into the actual review part of the video. So, who is this guy? Cause he certainly ain't Riddler. Not the Riddler I know. Why would he care if Joker laughs or not? Why would he care about Joker at all? He says that he finds Joker to be a mystery, a riddle that needs solving. What? Whatever. Since when is Eddie fixated on solving mysteries anyway? I thought he was obsessed with proving his intellectual superiority. That's always been his game. He thinks he's so damn clever and wants everyone to know it. Solving puzzles isn't really what he's about. He uses puzzles as a tool to show us how stupid we are compared to him. Of course, I can understand that perhaps if there was some big mystery that nobody could understand, including him, he'd be tempted to figure it out. After all, that would prove his superiority. That doesn't seem to be this Eddie's motivation though. He just likes solving mysteries. But doesn't he supply an answer to the mystery already anyway? He says it himself. The Joker can't laugh because his battles with Batman aren't fun any longer. So there it is. What else is there to it? Why does he need to make Joker laugh again? I just don't understand the motivations of this Riddler. It seems like he has a crush on Joker or something. He also claims that Batman is fun, but no challenge. But isn't it Batman who keeps solving his riddles and beating his ass? I guess what we have here is a brand new Riddler. Maybe I should just forget about the Chuck Dixon Riddler and the Riddler of the Golden and Silver Age. They're gone. And this is the Riddler we have in the current continuity. This Riddler is also far more sadistic than the usual depiction. He enjoys killing people, even kids. He keeps talking about murdering everyone's families. He seems to really like killing your loved ones. In fact, it's his shtick, as he keeps tabs on where everybody lives and who they live with, just in case he needs to go kill them. He's as sick as Victor Zsasz or the Joker himself. Usually Riddler is one of the less violent bat rogues, and often I find him fairly sympathetic and relatable. After all, he isn't out to hurt anyone, just prove that he's smart. But now that's gone and we have this deplorable bastard. Reading this story actually made me develop a distaste for the character. Of course, being the huge Riddler fan that I am, I quickly got over it. As for the Joker, I liked him better than Eddie. He's as crazy and murderous as usual, which is how it's supposed to be. He was also quite funny, in a very dark way, even though he himself didn't think so. I actually find this idea very interesting. The Joker can't see the humor in anything any longer, because he's grown bored with Batman. The problem is though that this story takes place after Bruce has been Batman for only a year. So how many times have he and Joker even fought? What, twice maybe? Why should Joker already be tired of their game? A concept like this only works if Batman and Joker have been at it for years. This story should have taken place a decade into Bruce's crusade. So yeah, Tom King kind of fails with the Joker too. I do like the overall portrayal though. Joker barely seems to care about anything, including the big war he's waging. He treats it all like it's some big joke. And I guess he's right. So, Kite Man, the guy who's generally considered to be Batman's lamest villain, ends up being the most important part of this story. Riddler's plot completely depends on him. Tom King decided to give old Charlie Brown a tragic origin here. He's a small-time loser criminal who loves kites for some reason and has a son. The son's also named Charlie Brown, don't ask me why. I was actually confused at first and thought that maybe it's the boy who becomes Kite Man in the future. After all, the story takes place in the past. Anyway, Riddler kills his son by poisoning the rope of a kite he was playing with, and it's this that set Charlie on his path to become Kite Man. Because he likes kites, and his son was killed by a kite. I don't know, isn't that pretty stupid? I appreciate that Kite Man actually got a compelling origin, but it still doesn't really work. It feels really forced, like a Silver Age origin. I see the bat signal in the sky, naturally I must become the Signal Man. This begs the question, how could Eddie possibly foresee that Charlie would adopt the identity of Kite Man? That was like the least likeliest outcome. Are we making a dark and edgy 2017 comic here, or a goofy 1950s comic? It's like it's trying to be both, and that doesn't quite work. Nevertheless, Kite Man was alright here. And it's obviously the best Kite Man story ever made, being that there's zero competition. A shame this new Kite Man has to be tied with this crappy arc. So let's talk about the rest of the rogues. After all, the story was promoted as a big war between all the Bat rogues, one side led by Joker and the other by Riddler. So how were the other rogues? Did they get their time to shine? Were their motivations for choosing their respective sides explained? The answers are no and no. Except for Poison Ivy and Penguin, I guess, concerning the latter. In Ivy's case, it's probably because Tom King was planning to use her for a later story, which is out right now, I believe. She's recruited by Riddler, who tells her that Joker is going to scorch the Earth if he wins the war. Of course, that convinces Pam to fight for Eddie. Yeah, okay, I guess I can buy it. It's a little flimsy, but it works. As for Pengy, he's portrayed as Carmine Falcone's assistant. Joker then kills Carmine and forces Pengy to become his assistant. Yeah, Pengy's pretty pathetic here. So, the rest of the rogues? Nothing. I was against this premise from the start. Why would any of these rogues take orders from either Joker or Riddler? I was hoping there would be a darn good explanation, but no. I kind of expected it to be like that though. I had a feeling they would all be portrayed as patsies, and they are. Glorified goons, basically. Seriously, why even use them? Couldn't this war just have been between Joker and Riddler and their respective goons? They already have armies on their own. What was the need for including the other villains? They're completely wasted, and none of them stand out, not even Ivy. They're just loyal soldiers doing the bidding of their master. It makes no sense. They're as dangerous as Joker and Riddler, and also have giant egos. They would never join either of them, or anyone else. Clearly, Tom King doesn't know these people. Guys like Two-Face and Scarecrow wouldn't suddenly bow down to Eddie Nigma. I mean, these guys can barely team up, not even on equal terms, due to their obsessive and narcissistic personalities. Each of them lives in their own little world, where they're the master. You can't just tell the Mad Hatter what to do. He's not going to comply. By the way, where the hell are all their goons? They should have armies too, and could easily have resisted any attempts at forcing them to join the war. The way I see it, when Riddler went to Harvey and asked him to join, he would say no, not even flip his coin, just straight up no. And if Eddie has a problem with that, then he finds himself at war with Harvey and his goons too. So actually, what would have happened is that Joker and Riddler would have to join forces, just to survive against all the enemies they would have made when doing their silly recruiting. By the way, why are all these rogues already established? This is supposed to take place a year after Batman's debut, and all the villains are already around. But not only that, well known too. It doesn't make any sense, and further reason why this story shouldn't have taken place early in Batman's career. As for Batman himself, I don't like the way he's written. He acts too mopey and melodramatic. It's just ridiculous the way he's relating the whole story to Selina. Like he's doing a weird, angsty monologue. Nobody talks like that. Certainly not Bruce Wayne. And Selina just sits there and takes it. In real life, she would have been like, Bruce, are you drunk? And why the hell do they call each other Bat and Cat? What is this? And having the rogues over for dinner in Wayne Manor? What the hell kind of crazy plan was that? He wants to talk it out with these mass murdering psychotic lunatics? I'm actually kind of confused. Is this story some sort of brilliant metaphor, or just incredibly badly written? At least the art is pretty good. I love that Selina was drawn with the 90s Jim Ballant costume for the scenes taking place in the past. That was awesome. The design for Joker is also really good. I like his outfits. They're not the classic Joker getup, yet still very much the Joker. The only thing I don't like about the art is Eddie. He looks like crap. Real boring design, and the question mark on his chest is cringy as hell. A bullet wound on his stomach acts as a dot, and he paints the rest with the blood of the wound. Then he walks around with his shirt unbuttoned to show it off. It's really stupid. I take the design from the Batman over this one. So there you have it. That's the War of Jokes and Riddles. Clearly not my favorite story. I wouldn't say I hate it, just greatly dislike it. So what did you think of it? Did you like it? If so, please write down why in the comments. And as always, remember, Arkham Asylum awaits you in the next video.